embassies, saints with joy. I also let my news us in his love in this mess. He feeds us with his living word. He nourishes us with his body and blood. I let the mercy of grace with the sake of reading. God looks on all that has brought us to this moment. And his food for the journey feeds us. Takes place at a time when these gospel themes are stressful than ever in understood outside the immigration probes of one of these fundamental things, problematic for the Church's way forward. Living in the new pontificate of Pope Francis, the expression missionary discipleship is so close to the charism of the MGLs, it is a favorite expression. The Australian-born missionaries of God's love, over the world, the hope, and the joy of the gospel. They are witness to the charismatic dimension of the Church. They find their apostolic energy in Eucharistic adoration and deep contemplation. In essence, they witness to the experience of God's love for us all. It is that prime charismatic gift of the Church. It enriches the Church with deeper holiness. The numerical growth has been impressive, and especially by Australian standards. Despite what pastors say regarding the religious profile of youth today in Australia, they are clearly feeding the deep and raw spiritual hungers of the youth of Australia and now beyond. All of us must look and listen carefully at what is taking place here. It is the work of the Holy Spirit in action. May the mysteries of God's love continue to seek out the presence of Jesus, especially in the poor of the world. The poor are God's microphones. They shout out deeply and clearly to all who care to listen, where Jesus can be found most fully. In the discovery of this new manger at Bethlehem, we find Jesus. He became poor so that we might become rich. We also find Mary, the mother of Jesus. Hey Mary, the new star of the new evangelization, guide and protect the mysteries of God's love from all harm as they journey towards Calvary with the suffering.